Namaste and welcome. Today, it's my pleasure and honor to introduce two directors from the India Association of Greater Boston, Mr. Veeresh Angadi and Vaishali Gade. Veeresh ji is the treasurer for IAGB and Vaishali is the vice president of the India Association of Greater Boston. Welcome, Vaishali. Welcome, Veeresh ji. Namaste.
Namaste.
So, Veeresh ji, I know that prior to joining IAGB, you have worked at Kannada Kuta, and also in your real life, in your other life, you serve as a software professional at a startup. So now, how long have you been with IAGB now?
So, this is my first term in IAGB. As a part of the executive committee.
Fantastic.
I'm in IAGB for the last couple of years as a member of IAGB.
Oh, I love that. I love that. So that's really great. And Vaishali, in your real life, you serve as a financial professional working with corporate finances. And I think this is your, I don't know, you've been with IAGB forever as far as I remember.
That's what I feel like, yes.
So obviously, it's an organization that you both really enjoy being part of. And this year, I know that the flagship programs of IAGB has been always the Republic Day and the Independence Day events. And COVID has asked you all to innovate in very, very creative ways to change the mode of these presentations. So maybe I'll start with you, Veeresh ji. You have transformed Republic Day from a single day event, as I remember it from many years ago, to really almost a festival, you know, for a whole, I think, few days, you know, running the gamut, you know, extending from cultural programs to competitions to learning series, and all this doing it in a virtual mode. So could you tell me a little bit, Veeresh ji, about what you have done thus far in this whole series of the Republic Day?
Yeah, IAGB as conducting the RD Republic Day event in the venue, including the competitions. But this year, everything become virtual, so including the competitions. And we basically started off with the Antakshari in December 19th. And since then, we are conducting various competitions for kids and adults. So competitions like chess, art competition, cake decorations, even storytelling. And Antakshari, we have an Antakshari coming up. The final Antakshari is on Friday, very, very close to the event. And we are preparing to present the best of the RD in a virtual environment.
And I saw that, you know, Antakshari has, you know, I think started a little while ago, and now it has become quite a very, very popular event that is happening with IAGB, and very, very competitive too, right? So yeah. Look forward to the grand finale that's going to happen. But in addition to that, you have had a lot of learning series. As I know, I attended a few of them. Would you like to tell about that? And what kind of themes did you use, you know, to get to this? I mean, competition was one aspect, but it looks like education was another very big aspect of what you were looking to do with these series.
Certainly. I'll add a little color to that. So, you know, I know we celebrate Republic Day year after year, and we do very many competitions, but we felt that, you know, understanding really the history behind where the Republic Day originated, how India became the republic that it is today, one of the second largest or third largest democracy in the world, and understanding the history behind how the Republic was written, who wrote it, what went into that. I mean, it was like almost a 20 years affair that we are where we are today with that republic. So that was one thing that we wanted to bring forward. And the other aspect, one more aspect that we covered through this series was the women in the independence, the women who really helped us gain the independence, and what role did they play. So those were the two things that was covered in depth with in collaboration with Shishu Bharati teachers. They did a wonderful, wonderful job. You know, some of the aspects I know we have learned in school, but many things that they brought forward, it almost felt like, for me at least, hey, I should pick up the book and go back and read the history one more time. So
yeah, no, no,
I hope people did feel that way.
Yeah, no, I have to say that, especially the series on women, you know, how many women were involved in the forming of the constitution, and you know, how many dynamic women were there. And what really interested me was they were not just from one state, or, you know, they were, that was very, very interesting, from, you know, whether it was from Punjab, you know, or Tamil Nadu or Kerala. We found a variety of, you know, states which had really great leading women. So thank you for that, Vaishali and Vireshji, for bringing that to us. So now, so all the competitions are now over. Am I right about that? Other than the finales?
All the competitions are over. And I mean, with the competitions, we pretty much did all of the competitions which we would do when we were meeting in person at Burlington High School. There is only one competition which we couldn't bring in virtual environment, which is carom. Of course, you can't play carom in the virtual environment. So that is the only competition we didn't bring this year. But we added a few more competitions. So, you know, it's fun. So, and all of those competitions are over. We added actually Bollywood quiz this year. We added Jeopardy this year. So those are the two new competitions that got added.
How did you do chess online? That sounds
chess
like...
Chess online, you know, I am amazed. It was quite a journey to do all of that online. But you know what, now looking back, I feel like, you know, that's our future. In future also, we'll do chess online. No, not in person.
So now onwards, if you're an IHGB director, you have to be very technically savvy, it seems. So our younger generation can really, you know, help us and kick it forward. So has it been a very great challenge, Vaishali, to move from... you know, in person, which is what we always did, onto the virtual environment? Was that a huge challenge?
It was a huge challenge, but with all the EC members working on it, Ranjani ji, you know, everybody took, accepted that challenge and took a competition upon themselves, yeah, and figured out the ways to implement that. And, you know, spotlighting, like storytelling, they figured out, okay, what are the challenges with the Zoom, make it in the break room. They figured out, okay, what can you do with the art competition? Even the baking competition was held as if it is a British baking show. And it is just amazing. I mean, if anybody wants, the recordings are out there, and just go and watch. Of course, yeah, the talent we have is amazing here. And I'm glad that we want to give.
I think we need the baking recipes anyway. So very, very important. And now that we've done all that, so what do you think? I can see behind you is the cultural extravaganza virtual background. So tell us more about what we are yet to expect. I think tomorrow you have a fireside chat, and would love to learn more about that.
Yes, so tomorrow we have the fireside chat coming up with Mary Milburn. Which is going to be moderated by Clint Poldaris of Berkeley Music School. Who is Mary Milburn? I mean, she is a well-known American singer. She has performed for past three consecutive presidents of the United States. And she is a performer. She's a theater actress. You know, she's a vivacious personality, and she's a cultural diplomat. That's how she goes. And that's what she's trying to establish herself as. And so it's going to be wonderful to understand how somebody in US with a very different background has embraced the Indian culture, and she's trying to learn about Indian culture. And you know, she's going to sing the US national anthem as well as Indian national anthem for the Republic Day on Saturday. And tomorrow's event, the fireside chat, is just a precursor to that, where we will get to know more about her.
That's amazing. I think the dream of IAGB right from the beginning was really to make Indian culture mainstream, you know, not to make it special or unique, you know, and that it should be only constrained to the Indian diaspora. So really kudos to you for bringing somebody like Mary, who has taken on Indian as, you know, Indian as is an Indian American, it doesn't matter what it is, it's all part of the American color and tapestry. So I think that's just fantastic. And I know that she's a tremendous singer. So really excited to hear her and to see what she has to perform. And I think you said that she had a great composition of Om Jai Jagadisha Hare. Is that right?
Absolutely. I mean, she, they shot a, filmed it in one of the church in Arizona, I want to say, one of the beautiful, beautiful churches. And, you know, you would understand that, you know, God is, no matter where you go, the divinity is just there. And that's, if you haven't checked, if, I mean, if viewers haven't checked it already, please go and check out that video where she sung the Om Jai Jagadisha Hare. With perfect accent, perfect pronunciation. It's amazing.
Look forward to listening to that, actually. That is absolutely, like you said, God is everywhere. Everybody can worship in any which way we want. And it's really nice to have Berklee College of Music. I mean, they are bringing a lot of Indian music into their you know, whole milieu as well. And Clint has been quite a, you know, leader in that space. So I think that's really fantastic. And more about the extravaganza. Now tell us that. I mean, that's what we used to look forward to each year, you know, so.
Definitely, definitely. So we do have the Grand Celebration Day. After all this, the Grand Celebration Day is Saturday. Vinesh, do you want to start off with, you know, our chief guest?
Sure. So this time, Consul General of New York, India, you'll be the chief guest for the RD on Saturday. So again, it is virtual. So he'll be there to greet us, greet all everyone on the occasion of Republic Day.
That's great. I like that the new way of speaking is no longer Republic Day, it's RD. You know, I like that. We have moved into texting mode, I can tell. So I'm sure. There. And I think, Virish Ji, you were telling before that there was the food that we used to eat in those wonderful things, instead of that, you're doing something creative to support our restaurants. Could you tell us that little bit about that?
That's right. So this time we are collaborating with the one of the Desi Food Hub company. Basically, they are the startup to cater the food on the day of the event. So basically to help the local businesses at this time. And also enjoy the food, order the food. And food will be basically the way this works is go to their website, order the food. And they have a partnership with four different restaurants. Mm-hmm. And they will be delivering the food to 13 different pickup points. So it's very close to the location in around the Mass and near the cities around the state, like neighboring cities and states. Okay. So with that, they can order the food and they can pick up before the event starts. And while watching the event, they can, you know, enjoy the food and watch the event.
Yeah, I think I was telling my husband that I miss samosas. In the real events, we were eating samosas once a week, yes. You know, and now nobody gets samosas anymore. So I think this is great. We'll certainly order the food. And then, so I don't have to cook. We just enjoy the, you know, evening. And I think that that's something that we really look forward to. So what is the highlight of the cultural program, Vaishali? We always look forward to that. Republic Days are some of the best showcase. So tell us more about that.
They are. So certainly this year, again, you know, we are talking about challenges here. And again, the team came together, brainstormed things. And we wanted to showcase, though I know nobody can be on the stage and nobody can be, you know, there are some certain restrictions. But despite of that, we wanted to showcase something that is very unique and hasn't been watched before. We say that, you know, these times has presented the challenges, but it has also given us the opportunity. And the opportunity came in the form of, you know, this video conferencing. You do not rely just on this. You have an opportunity to get something far away as India. And that's what we have done. We have actually worked with very many dance schools and choreographers, not only just here in New England area, but also back home in India. And we have beautiful, beautiful pieces from different east, west, south, north, south of the India region, and showcasing you the, giving you the flavor of each one of those region, the things that you probably have never seen before, and just the admire the diversity that we have, and at the same time, be proud that the unity that we have with this diversity.
And I think what you're saying is that the quality of the program will obviously be very high, while you're also supporting the artists. I think they also are suffering a little bit in India, the live performers. So I'm so glad. Am I right about that, Vaishali?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You are right. Many people were actually, they were very willing, and they were so thrilled that, oh, you guys are celebrating Republic Day. Oh, you are celebrating it there. Like, yes, we do this every year. And this year we are grateful that you are supporting us. So it was really a win-win situation for all.
I believe that. I absolutely believe that. While I look forward to next year, when we hope we do it in person. I mean, I think the Republic Day was the time the entire Indian community comes together. It was one place where, it didn't matter you're Punjabi, Gujarati, Bengali, you're all in one place, as Indians and as Indian Americans, and often very many Americans are also, non-India, in diaspora Americans are also there. So look forward to that next year, but really kudos to all of you for having to, reshaped the whole program. And I remember the Independence Day where we had a beautiful presentation from, the Kathak presentation from, Prabhat, Nirupama and Rajendra, and the music presentation to Anuradhaji. So just fantastic. So I am sure it's going to be spectacular. So absolutely. Before we sign off here, Vireshji, any final messages for our Lokvani viewers?
So sure. You should also talk about the concert, the Suresh Bhosle and Vaishali Mande, which will be the highlight of the evening.
Oh my goodness, I'm missing that. Please, Vireshji, please tell us more about that.
Yeah, on the day of the event, this is the main entertainment
attraction.
Program. Yes, it's very attracting program on the day of the event. And two of the famous singers from India, they are presenting this singing. So it's going to be really entertaining to watch both Vaishali and
Sudeshji.
So both of them, yeah, they're both famous singers.
Yeah.
And it'll be really great to watch on the day of the event. And at the same time, enjoy the food. So we don't have to cook. I mean, just order and pick up the food before the event and sit and relax, enjoy the event.
So it's a Bollywood kind of music?
It is a Bollywood kind of concert. Suresh Bhosle, he's a playback singer. So is Vaishali Mande. Vaishali Mande is upcoming playback singer. She's actually the winner of Saregama competition, and she also won a couple Filmfare awards. And Suresh ji is also, she's also not only for playback singing, he's also famous for mimicry. He's an actor in itself. So that is going to be an entertaining plus the music. So it's going to be a really concert type of setting, and fun evening from the comfort of all our homes.
Of course. And I won't forget the food, as Vireshji points out. So,
yeah.
So any final words of wisdom, Vaishali, for our viewers? What do you suggest they do?
Yes. Do come together. Do watch the show. This is our chance to showcase our pride, celebrating the Republic Day, and be with the community and enjoy.
That's great. This time we don't have to worry about the weather because we'll be just at home. So
yes.
I remember all.
We do not have a snow day planned.
No day. I know. We used to always worry about that, right? And I watched the snow and I was thinking about that we don't need to be concerned about that anymore. And I think if they go to iagb.org, they can see all the events there. Is that how do we get to it?
Today? Yes. So these two, all of them, in the whole evening events will be streamed on the IIGB's Facebook page as well as IIGB's YouTube channel. So you can just stream it directly to your TV or your computer, and they will be there. They are available to all. All are welcome to join us and celebrate. So please.
Also, what I'm thinking is that the previous events as well, the learning seminars, are all there on the Facebook and on the...
Correct, correct. Right? So learning series. Yeah, if you miss to attend that day, they are available on the Facebook as well as YouTube channel. They are there. They will stay there for at least another few days before...
Wonderful. Well, thank you, Vaishali. Thank you, Virajji, for taking the time to talk to us. And congratulations for putting this hard work, really. It's not trivial to do what you're doing. So hats off to both of you and the entire team. I know it's a great team that works very well together. And I've seen you all taking responsibilities for different parts of the event and really doing a fantastic job. So I look forward to spending the time with you virtually. And God bless you as you're celebrating this beautiful Republic Day. Thank you very much.
Namaste. Thank you, Ranjani ji. Thank you, Lokwani.
Thank you. Thank you. Yep.